Thank you so much. I'm here with Bronson Reed. And Bronson, you came into 2024, one of WWE's top prospects. But lately, things haven't exactly gone your way. In fact, last week after the Gauntlet match, you tweeted, and I quote, "No chamber, no mania, how the mighty have fallen." Where does Bronson Reed go from here?
Well, I tweeted that because 2024 was supposed to be a big year for big Bronson Reed. And so far, things aren't going the way I planned. I don't know if that's from some missteps or bad timing, but I'm ready for all of that to change. You know, I am a natural-born winner, and I have a new driving force in my life, and I'm going to change all of my soons into finally, because I am sick of being a vehicle for others to get to their destination. From now on, I'm in the driver's seat, and I'm going to where I want to go. So strap yourself in. Buckle up tight, because it's going to be a hell of a ride.
Bronson, thank you for the time. As we send it back to you in studio, I don't think there's anything else that needs to be said. Bronson Reed made it pretty clear. Thank you so much. I'm standing by with Ivy Nile. And Ivy, you made it pretty clear tonight that you are not happy with the way Candice LeRae has been treating Maxine. But what motivated you to react the way that you did tonight?
Look, it's simple. Maxine is my friend. You know what? And she's new at this. She works hard every single day while Candice is walking around whining about not getting what she wants. So next week, I'm going to give Candice the hurt that she's been giving out.
All right. Thank you for the time. Megan, let's send it back to you in studio.
Thanks, guys. I am joined by the New Day and very important victory out there tonight. Congratulations. What do you think it was that helped you secure that win?
Oh, man, you know what? I'll tell you what. Between Otis and Tozawa, a lot of people don't take them seriously as a tag team. They put up a lot more of a fight than I thought they would. And I'll tell you, they definitely earned my respect tonight.
100%. But I think the thing that gave us the edge in that is just experience as a tag team.
That's it.
They showed a lot of fight out there. And I think the more that they're in the ring together, the better they're going to get. But tonight, you know, we had to stamp our ticket to WrestleMania.
Yeah. Well, speaking of experience as a tag team, 0 wins at WrestleMania for you, 1 win at WrestleMania for Kofi. What does this mean to be in this ladder match at WrestleMania, and what would a win mean at WrestleMania 40?
Honestly, this is our chance. Last year, we weren't in any matches at Mania. And honestly, we have entered Mania as tag team champions before, but we have never left Mania as tag team champions. And that's something that has eluded us for a long time now. And honestly, this feels like this is going to be the one.
It does. It does. It's something like where, you know what, like, we've been in a lot of WrestleManias, but you never take it for granted. Anytime you go out there, the biggest show in the history of sports and entertainment, man, the energy is so unique and so special. But like Wood said, and like you said, we have not left WrestleMania as tag team champions. So as many Manias as we've been in, we still have goals. You know what I mean?
Yep.
We still got goals, so this might be the one. But we walk out as your
WWE World Tag Team Champions.
And we're going to add another one to being the most decorated tag team in WWE history. You know. You know.
Don't be afraid to move your hips like we do.
Go ahead.
Maybe at WrestleMania. Maybe at WrestleMania. I imagine the preparation starting tomorrow. I'll start preparing my hips for the WrestleMania celebration. But in the meantime, I'm going to send it back to you guys in the studio.
Born to be the greatest of all time. This is where I draw the line. Can't stop my shine. They know it's my time. Let the world know I've arrived. I'm on the rise. Unstoppable.